Now, before we start, I would like to point out that I don't think Actman's video should have been taken down, nor do I believe he should have been demonetized. In terms of the whole Actman versus Quantum TV drama, I'm on Actman's side 100%. With that being said, let's take a look at things now that everyone's emotions have calmed down a bit, so we can get a proper judgment on what exactly has been going on the past few months. So while I was on vacation throughout June, I was sorta kinda keeping up with any sort of internet news that I could get my hands on. One thing I didn't expect to be talking about again was the Actman and Quantum TV drama, because I frankly thought it would be over soon. Last we talked about it, Actman was sending in a report to YouTube, going over all the nasty things that Quantum TV had done, ranging from false striking people, homophobic statements, and potential ban evasion. At the time, I left the situation at that and moved on to other video projects, and I never expected to go over this much further past my initial video. However, the stuff that went down afterwards was not what I was expecting, so let's take a look and see what we missed out on since my last video. So, last we saw, Actman was asking for screenshots and other pieces of evidence from people of Quantum TV abusing false copyright and other heinous things that he had done. Actman would keep people updated on his Twitter about what was going on, such as Quantum TV still threatening to drag his mother into a lawsuit between the two of them. The conversation isn't too much, it's mainly just Quantum saying how he's willing to go through the entire legal process to prove that he didn't threaten his mother and asking if Actman is ready for things to go down in the future, some wannabe supervillain type shit to be honest. At the end of May, Actman would post on Twitter that after going over all the evidence he gave to YouTube, they decided that Quantum TV did not violate any of their community guidelines and that they would not be taking any action on his channel. Needless to say, Actman was very pissed at this outcome, and he stated he would make his own video and that he wins every case he deals with. This came as a shock to everyone keeping up with the situation, as it seemed Quantum TV was destined to get his YouTube channel taken down, given all the drama surrounding his name, and so within 2 days after Actman's post on Twitter, he would release a video titled The Dark Age of YouTube, Quantum TV Found Innocent, going over why Quantum TV should be banned off the site. The video is a pretty heavy one, and one that is full of a lot of information and convincing arguments to go over. The main things that Actman pins on Quantum is ban evasion, that he's been avoiding a ban on the site through multiple channels, copyright abuse as he's threatened multiple channels to falsely take down their videos, hate speech as Quantum has been proven to say some pretty nasty damn things throughout his time off the platform, and scamming as Quantum has been giving faulty TV settings throughout his time on his platform. As far as copyright abuse goes, let's be real people, ain't nobody defending him for that. The guy tried to bully Mischief into taking down his Elden Ring review and sent in a false strike to Actman. Quantum is easily guilty for that one. With hate speech, it's a tough one, because we know that Quantum is a bad person. Y'all have seen some of the deleted tweets, I'm putting them on screen right for y'all, but YouTube doesn't look into deleted tweets as evidence. Now, I understand why though, as if YouTube looked into deleted tweets or messages as evidence, ironically enough, Actman should be banned off the platform for his past tweets. Don't get it twisted though, I'm not calling for Actman to get banned, I'm just showing an example on why I understand why YouTube doesn't use deleted messages as evidence. It makes sense to me and is a good rule overall. Besides, even if Quantum won't get banned off the site despite those messages, the court of public opinion will shun him for the rest of his hateful days anyway. As far as scamming goes, while Quantum selling bad TV settings certainly is a shitty thing to do, what he does isn't against YouTube TOS of scamming, as he isn't running any sort of get-rich-quick scheme or cash giveaway, he's just giving really bad TV settings that make it look like shit. Still a bad thing to do though, to pretend like you're the know-it-all TV man when you can't even do that job right. With all that being said, the big one here, and the one that I find the most interesting, is the ban evasion, because Actman puts up a damn solid case for why Quantum TV is ban evading and that his channel should be terminated. Where things get interesting is that Quantum had a rebuttal for this, and finds a video from 2018 with a link in the description to his old Quantum Apotheosis channel, which now leads to Next Gen Gamers. When seeing this, one may think that the channel must have gotten reinstated at one point, as YouTube gives you a single chance to reinstate a terminated account. Actman comes up with the theory that Quantum TV must have changed the custom URL on Next Gen Gamers to that link in the description, and still calls for Quantum's termination without testing the theory out.
Quantum claims this link leads to the missing channel Apotheosis. So I asked myself, what would happen if I put this link into the Wayback Machine? There it is. Irrefutable. indisputable evidence of Banavasion. Quite a remarkable coincidence. So what really happened? Quantum Apotheosis was banned for hate speech. Out of fear his other channels would be taken down, he privated Next Gen Gamers to prevent people from reporting it to YouTube, but forgot about it until just recently. 4 years later, to throw off suspicion for his ban evasion, he found this video, made Next Gen Gamers public again, and changed the custom URL to the one listed in the description to make it look as if Quantum Apotheosis was never banned.
So, I decided to take it a step further and give it a test myself, and what I came up with was something that I was not expecting. So, you have two URLs to work with on YouTube, your permanent unique one and your custom one. As you can see, when I look up my channel using my custom URL, my channel obviously comes up and I've led right to it. And of course, when looking up my channel through my permanent URL, it comes up as well, either through the Your Channel option when in my settings or through Google when clicking on the link. In the video Quantum used to defend himself, Actman says that the custom URL is the one being used, but if we were to look up the channel in the search bar typing Next Gen Gamers instead of the URL, this same channel comes up, meaning that the custom URL name is the channel name Next Gen Gamers, and Quantum TV is not using the custom URL option to hide behind his banned channel like Actman hypothesized. Next Gen Gamers was Quantum Apotheosis, and he was able to get it reinstated at one point in time, meaning that while yes, he did get banned off the site at one point, YouTube themselves unbanned him by their own discretion, thus showing that Quantum TV is not ban evading like Actman had been saying. Now, after seeing that Quantum got unbanned off the site, I decided to take it a step further and try and pinpoint a rough date when that happened. What I found was even more interesting than finding out he got unbanned. If you use the permanent channel URL in the Wayback Machine, you get a couple links, the most important ones being June 13th, 2018, when Quantum Apotheosis was banned, and June 5th, 2022, when the first snapshot of Next Gen Gamers was taken. In between these two is April 21st, 2022, and when clicking on that snapshot, you're led to Quantum Apotheosis still banned from the website. Around April 21st, this is when the Quantum TV drama was getting to all-time highs, as people all over the internet were gunning for Actman to kick his ass after he tried to false copyright strike his video down. Also around this time is when Actman released his first video on Quantum TV on April 23rd, bringing more attention to the fact that Quantum TV was evading a previous ban on the Quantum Apotheosis channel.
Quantum TV's been evading a previous ban on YouTube.
Quantum TV will end up releasing a video on May 16th stating that the Quantum Apotheosis channel was never banned, showing that the Quantum Apotheosis channel is now Next Gen Gamers. However, as we've seen before, it was banned as recently as April 21st of this very year, and going on Social Blade shows that on May 15th, the channel was made public again along with Quantum deleting a handful of videos. That shows that between April 21st, 2022 to May 15th, 2022, during the middle of all this drama, Quantum TV must have seen a bunch of people trying to get him banned for ban evading, so he sent in an appeal to YouTube and somehow won. He then made this video and released it on May 16th to try and get the own on everyone before unlisting it, lying that he was never banned on the site when he clearly was, but by putting the pieces together myself, we can see that YouTube unbanned him only very recently and in the middle of the controversy to boot. This is a very, very weird situation to go over, because we all know that Quantum TV was lying about not being banned, we knew he was banned and that he was ban evading, but now we also know that he was unbanned between April 21st to May 15th in the middle of the drama, which points the finger back at YouTube. By the time Actman released his video proving that Quantum was ban evading, in a weird way he was both right and wrong. We already knew he was ban evading, but by the time the video came out with all that proof, YouTube had already unbanned him from their site, even though they had their chance to ban him and end things. As for why YouTube unbanned Quantum Apotheosis, I don't think we'll ever get an answer for that. The only possible thing I can think of is that they didn't do their research and didn't realize what he was doing on the site until after they unbanned him, and once they were made aware of all the things he was doing, it was too late to do anything, as ever since then, Quantum has been playing coy by TOS ever since. That's the only rational thing I can think of, but it's clear YouTube had their chance and squandered it. If you thought this was the end of the drama, it's not, because there is so much more to cover. Soon after releasing The Dark Age of YouTube, it was taken down from the website 5 days later for a community guideline strike for nudity or sexual content. There's no discernible reason as to why it was struck down, as nudity and sexual content is very vague, and the only thing people could come up with was the picture of Quantum TV with a cucumber in his mouth, an obvious implication against the homophobic man. However, I have a theory that makes me think there was more to this strike than just the sexual content, and it all has to do with what transpires after. At first, it was just two videos getting conveniently age-restricted on the website, but then things would take a turn in a very unexpected direction. Back on Twitter, Actman was posting these obviously satirical joke tweets shitting on YouTube for not banning Quantum, such as using his channel to promote hate speech onto others and planning to copyright strike other channels for the hell of it. An especially edgy one had Actman taking the piss out of the both of them by saying he would start a new YouTube series doxing the employees of the site and their family members. It's clearly a really edgy joke taking the piss out of both YouTube and Quantum to anyone and everyone keeping up with the drama, but that very tweet would have a dire impact on the future of the Actman YouTube channel. On June 8th, Actman would announce that his partner manager reached out to him to say that he'd be removed from the YouTube partnership program at some point in time, and that his channel would be completely demonetized. 4 hours later, he would be officially demonetized, and to say that people were furious was a massive understatement. Here we had someone who was leading the charge against Quantum TV with heaps of evidence against him, and instead of YouTube banning him from the site, they would say there was no wrongdoing, and to top it all off would penalize Actman for what seemed to be no reason. It turns out, however, that YouTube would say as the discussion went, he was demonetized because of that very edgy doxing tweet that he made, not for anything else in particular. Now, what I think happened here is that YouTube saw how Actman was taking things into his own hands, inciting his massive 1 million plus subscriber audience to get their pitchforks and go after Quantum TV along with him in his video. On top of that, on Twitter, he was implying that YouTube protects hateful people, and when you mess with YouTube like that and affect their brand, there's no doubt you'll be on their shit list, and they were watching him like a damn hawk. People were stating how it's unfair for YouTube to demonetize him based off a deleted tweet as they would have applied that to Quantum, but it turns out that it was YouTube themselves who told him to take down the tweet.
June 3rd, 4th, 5th, I posted the satirical tweets. And then the one about doxing adventures, they asked me to take it down through the partner manager, and so I did. The tweet was only up for about 5 hours, and so I thought that would be the end of it. The tweet was up for 5 hours before I deleted it. Because they asked me to, and then they demonetized the channel anyways.
Well, it sounds like somebody lower asked you to pull it down to try to save you, and then somebody up at the top like found it, possibly. And
that's exactly what I was thinking.
Just as the people were saying, it sounded like someone lower on YouTube saw his tweet and tried to save his ass, but the higher-ups already saw it and finally had their reason to penalize him for taking matters into his own hands. To put it short, they made a message out of him, and that message was to not take things into your own hands unless you want to face the consequences, in this case, demonetization. Now, after seeing that YouTube were the ones that came out and said it was because of the tweet and not Actman, some people were a little bit ticked off they had to learn of it through YouTube, though an interview with Philip DeFranco does confirm he knew why, but was unsure to make it public or not given the circumstances surrounding the entire situation, which is understandable if you ask me.
I did want to confirm, did they communicate that was the reason, just because I didn't find anything about that public prior to them issuing that statement.
I suppose if it's out now, then I can't say yes, that was communicated to me. I didn't want to say anything about it because I was told that, and I wasn't sure if I should share the reason. Again, because it's kind of like a sensitive topic. Right. We're talking about, you know, doxing people and families getting involved. So I chose not to relay that information to people.
As I'm sure you guys can see by now, it's pretty obvious that YouTube unbanned Quantum in the middle of this drama, and that when Actman started to take matters into his own hands, they made a lesson out of him for what happens when you don't listen to him. That's not to say Actman is 100% in the right with this drama either, however, as implying YouTube sides with hateful people because he didn't get his way is pretty childish if you ask me, even if he has an understandable reason for why he started reaching so far to villainize a website in the first place. There's no evidence that YouTube was malicious with their decision to unban Quantum, but rather they were ignorant instead and didn't do the proper research. It's unfortunate that they unbanned him before the heaps of evidence showing he was ban evading caught their attention, but we can't do anything about that other than move on and try to figure out our next move. And attacking the website by implying they condone hateful people and actions was not the right move to make. Actman clearly let his emotions get the best of him with those tweets, and unfortunately YouTube made him pay the price for it. Some more drama would ensue, as a YouTuber named Tommy C was making comments critical of Actman and his handling of the situation, and soon enough the two of them started to go at it with each other on Twitter. Now their argument was pretty bare bones, to be honest. Actman was basically ego tripping in DMs for a minute, and nothing of substance really went down. But then things took a turn on June 13th, when Tommy C got J Station to make a calling Actman's mom at 3 a.m. video.
What's
up, guys? Welcome back to another 3 a.m. challenge. Today, we are calling Ant-Man's mom at 3 a.m. Oh my god, what is she gonna do, guys? Let's smash the like button right now, guys. Let's get it. All right, guys, we got Mommy Ant-Man's phone number right here. I am so scared to do this. Okay, we're gonna call her. It's calling right now. Okay, I don't know if she's gonna pick up.
Hello?
Hello, is this Ant-Man's mom?
Who's calling?
What up, bitch?
It's very clear the video was taking the piss out of the Act-Man, and it was an obvious joke about a serious situation, and it's very comparable to the tweets that Act-Man made about YouTube. Both are edgy jokes making fun of a serious situation, and anybody with common sense knows that they're just that, edgy jokes. What makes the situation funny to me is that even though Act-Man acknowledges that it was an obvious joke, he starts to tweet about how having banned YouTubers on your platform is against TOS, and that YouTube has the right to take action against him because of it. Act-Man is basically dog whistling, which is like implying for someone to do something without outright saying it, in this case for people to go and report Tommy C's video. Act-Man is technically correct. Posting content from a creator who is terminated is against TOS, YouTube does have the right to take it down. But to try and play YouTube TOS God because someone made fun of him was another example of Act-Man letting his emotions get the best of him. Yeah, JStation can't be in any other YouTube videos anymore, but the same can also be said for EDP445, someone that is brought up and shown countless times in video topics. It gets even weirder though, as he would have an interaction with someone on Twitter, and he would deflect and double down saying that JStation isn't allowed on YouTube, and that's against TOS to upload content from a restricted user, and then say because it affects him personally, he's not being as lenient as he normally would. So according to Act-Man himself, because it's personal, he is now the judge on whether someone can upload content from a banned user. I'm sure you guys get the point already, but it's clear that Act-Man was trying to play both sides, as he knows people realistically don't give a fuck if a banned user is in someone's video on YouTube or not, but in this case he does because he's butthurt someone's making fun of him. On top of that, I highly doubt YouTube would ban anybody that Act-Man wants to be banned, because they know if they do, they would indirectly justify his current crusade as the wannabe YouTube TOS god, and other people would start to play the same game as him, trying to get people they don't like banned, as they would want a piece of that power as well. Act-Man don't gotta like Tommy C in the video that he posted, but he can't play YouTube TOS god either. Act-Man would go on to say that his joke video was not ban-worthy, but it was strike-worthy, so using that same kind of punishment, Act-Man's tweets on YouTube weren't ban-worthy, but they were demonetization-worthy. I'm just keeping the logic consistent here, but you guys see what I'm trying to say. To add to that, YouTuber Nicholas Dioria would leak DMs he had with Act-Man, showing that he was threatening to strike down Tommy C's video, so now people are seeing that Act-Man had malicious intent from the very beginning once he was made aware of Tommy C's upload. The very thing that Quantum was getting called out for was trying to get videos taken down that were critical or satirical of him because he didn't like him, and now Act-Man is bragging to other YouTubers how he'll strike a satirical video down because he doesn't like it, and hides behind the TOS to try and justify his pettiness to the public crowd on Twitter. With all that being said, Act-Man did delete all these tweets after he got his head together and calmed down, and did apologize to Tommy C in private, who basically said it was a bunch of bullshit and he didn't believe it.
It's buds for you, Act-Man. So, here is the problem with this. All of it's bullshit.
And later on in a stream with Rich from ReviewTech USA, Act-Man admits he got way over his head and too emotional with the Tommy C stuff and acted out in the heat of the moment.
Act-Man avoiding the question, why did I go after Tommy C? Well, because I was angry and it was in the heat of the moment and it was a mistake to do that. But, I just had a lot of stuff going on and a lot of stuff hitting me all at once, but I realized my mistake, and the whole point of that Tommy C thing is that, like, yeah, you know, his joke was fine, and there's nothing wrong with that. I was upset by it at first, but I'm not anymore, and that's the whole point, is that my jokes were clearly jokes and not malicious, as were his, and they should both be protected, and they shouldn't be striked or demonetized because of it.
It's good to see that he understood his mistake and that he got emotional over it, but hopefully Act-Man doesn't act this way again, otherwise this would become a pattern of behavior and not just a one-off thing. Speaking of ReviewTech USA, he quit his channel after getting a strike for implying Quantum TV was still in the closet in a stream clip. He made a bunch of tweets about it and all that, and then walked it all back like a week later after getting his head screwed back on. I was told he was known for acting out emotionally like this sometimes, so I guess all I can say about this is for him to not act so emotional online? I don't know, it didn't seem like that big of a deal like some people were saying when I was talking about it with him, but it's still worth mentioning here as he was really the only person who got unexpectedly fucked a bit in this drama. That's pretty much the point we're at today. Actman is currently demonetized indefinitely after trying to take matters into his own hands, though he did get his Cyberpunk 2077 video unage-restricted, so good stuff on that. Now, Quantum TV has kinda just been existing, to be honest. People are still shitting on him like expected, and he's still saying insane stuff, like how because he's a vegan, he can't be homophobic.
Now, one of the talking points they've been trying to cancel me with for the longest time is saying that I'm some homophobic, you guys, you know, the whole spiel that they push out. Let me just kind of put this out there. It'd be very hard to be a vegan like I am and be homophobic. A vegan literally can't be homophobic. If I'm so homophobic, why would I support their businesses?
Yeah, I have no idea what's up with that dude. I mean, we already know he's a pathological liar and complete asshole, but he seriously thought to himself that he would be epically owning everybody by saying this in his video, so who knows what the hell goes on inside his head. This drama got to a very unexpected level, though because now that we've gone over what happened a few weeks later, we can put things together in a much better light without letting our emotions get in the way. It's obvious that right after YouTube saw Actman's Dark Age video, they were looking for any possible reason to screw him over, as he was trying to take matters into his own hands and not listening to their jurisdiction, and so nitpicked for a reason to take his video down. As far as that goes, the only possible reason it could have been taken down for sexual content would be the Photoshop of Quantum TV with the cucumber in his face with obvious implications. What confirms that to me is Rich got a strike for making implications just like that, so there's no doubt in my head that's the reason why they struck Actman's video down. Quantum TV was banned at one point on YouTube, and during the middle of all this drama got unbanned by YouTube themselves, and so took it to the site to get the own on everyone, which in the end turned things back on YouTube because they had their chance to ban him and missed it. Actman was making those obvious satirical joke tweets about YouTube not doing their job, and since YouTube was watching him like a hawk, once they saw the doxing satirical joke tweet, they made an example out of him of what happens when you try to take things into your own hands. It's extremely screwed up, and only further proves that YouTube only has their interests in mind and not the community's, but it happened and there's nothing Actman can do about it other than reapply for monetization whenever he can again. It's clear that this drama turned into a giant mess of three entities all trying to go at each other's throats. Quantum TV, Actman, and YouTube. They're all out for each other, and frankly, nobody got out of this in a positive way. Quantum's entire internet image has been shattered after people learned of his awful behavior. Actman has potentially lost his entire livelihood, and YouTube showed people that they screwed up by unbanning Quantum without researching the proper evidence and with how they enforced their TOS on the platform. The only person who caught a dub in this situation was Mischief, who is doing quite fine on his YouTube channel now, at currently over 170,000 subscribers. At the end of it all, here we had a very interesting situation to go over. As we gather it all together, I get why Actman has been acting out the way he has. Quantum TV got his family involved in their petty internet beef, and I don't blame him for going scorched earth on his ass. Quantum is a massive pussy and has been sneaking around like a weasel ever since he got unbanned because he knows YouTube is watching him like a hawk now too. We saw what happens when you let your emotions get the best of you, and yet at the end of it all falls back on YouTube. YouTube had their chance to ban Quantum and they missed it, plain and simple. It's a shitty situation for everybody involved, but I do hope that people can check it out and apply it to anything they might deal with in the future, because Actman didn't deserve to get demonetized after what he was put through. I hope Actman gets it back soon, because with all things considered, it was Quantum TV that started this entire mess, all back when he threatened to strike Mischief over his critique on his bad Elden Ring review. I guess the only question left is, why did YouTube unban Quantum TV? There's a bunch of theories people are throwing about, and I feel it would be a good idea for y'all to tell me yours in the comments below, because I frankly have barely any idea myself. Thank you for watching today's video, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did enjoy it, make sure to like and subscribe, and as always, with all of that out of the way, I will see you guys later.